Hi, dear friends, cultural creatives and seekers everywhere. Bruce here with a very important distinction to be made, and that is about the nature of epigenetics and the environment. What do I mean by this? Well, I understood the nature of epigenetics back in the late 60s, early 70s, about how the environment of the cells were controlling the genetics of that cell. And it took up until the 90s before conventional science accepted this and actually gave us a meaning behind the new science of epigenetics. Environment influences cells. And I go, this is absolutely true. But then how come in biology belief I talk about our mind and our perception controlling our genetics? If a cell is out in the environment, consider an amoeba moving through the environment. Indeed, all environmental influences are now going to affect the behavior and activity of that cell. But then I say, well, wait, do those cells actually see the real environment in which we're in? I go, no, the cells in your body are covered up by the skin, disconnected from the environment. But in order to survive, these cells have to adjust their genetics and their behavior to adapt and maintain their survival in a changing environment. So the question is, then how do the cells inside your body actually know what's going on in the real world because they're not connected to it? I go, this is the role of the nervous system. The nervous system's job is to read environmental signals and then relay those signals into the cell. So as illustrated right here, we are getting signals from two different environments in our body. Signals from within our body as well as signals from without our body, and the function of the nervous system is to read both of these environments. The relevance is the nervous system reads the information in the environment and then translates it into signals that are sent to the 50 trillion cells inside your body to alert them to what is going on in that world. So, in fact, that is a true statement. The environment is controlling the behavior of your cells. But the mind does an interpretation of those signals based on our life experiences. Now, for a lot of people, this seems difficult, but let's put it in a different context because we can talk about computers. There's a very interesting fact about our brain as a computer because it has an autocorrect mechanism built into the subconscious. Meaning what? Well, I can have my conscious mind like typing on the computer about what's going on in the world. But if I type something, that signal can be translated and sent to the cells. But if I type something that the subconscious has no recognition of, it will do like an autocorrect and change what I wrote to fit something that it thinks that I wrote as a subconscious. So I put in love and subconscious changes that to live. That's a whole different meaning at this point because of misinterpretation. So the point is, your wishes and desires of your conscious mind are filtered by the programs in your subconscious mind. And if you have a wish or desire that doesn't conform to a program that already exists, then the subconscious mind's job is to retranslate that into something that makes sense for the subconscious belief, not for the conscious. So we may have wonderful wishes and desires, and if it doesn't conform to the programs that we receive, the subconscious will change those into something it understands. To make sense out of what I just said, consider using your cell phone. That you write something in your cell phone, such as, let's put the word epigenetics in the cell phone. And I go, when I type epigenetics in, the database in the phone says, I don't know that word at all. And then what does it do? It throws up different options that could be closely related to epigenetics. And so the significance is, if I put something into my system that is not supported by the program, then the programming system will change whatever I did to accommodate what it believes is right. Now, the issue about this is, well, if I want to have epigenetics in my phone, then what I really have to do is open up my dictionary and add the word epigenetics. And now after that, anytime I write epigenetics, the phone mechanism will understand what I'm talking about. Well, going into the database and changing the program is the function of what energy psychology is all about. It says if your behavior is not conforming to your wishes and desires, then it will be necessary to go into your program and install new behaviors that you want to manifest. So now the brain will have a reflection or a resource of what you're talking about. So I really want to emphasize the nature of biology belief as different than the fact that just environment controls your genes. And I'll give you a very simple example of what I mean by that, by the fact that I can have two people in the very exact same environment, but each of these individuals has a totally different reaction to the environment. So if it was just environment that controlled your genes and your behavior, then both individuals should have exact same behavior. But the reality is no. The two people have different responses to the environment. I go, why? Same environment. But their minds have different interpretations. And it's the interpretation of the mind about that environment that is sent to the cells. So the important part is this. Yes, environment controls epigenetics. There's an external environment, but an internal environment. And yet recognizing humans, the internal environment is not a direct readout from the external world. It's an interpretation of that external world. And that's why each of us has a different response to the world in which we live. And that is why the biology of belief is an extension of the foundation that environment controls epigenetics.